So let's have a look at substrings. So I'm going to introduce this new computer variable called str underscore subset, just by my choice. And inside of it, I'm going to put the string. I love Julia, exclamation mark. I use the semicolon, so it does not, there's no output to the screen. First things first, let's count the number of characters in our little string. And we've seen this before, the length function, and inside of that the argument is this computer variable str underscore subset. If we run that, we see there are 13, and indeed if we count it, we notice that we have to count the spaces. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 characters. Now let's do a little loop just so that we can see what happens. Now what I'm going to do here, so let's bring that up a little bit. I'm going to say for I in 1 to the length of str underscore subset, that means 13. So for I in 1 to 13, so it's going to loop through 1, 2, 3, 4 until we get 13, print the following. The following that I wanted to print is a string, and the string says character, and then it is this placeholder, $i. So the first thing is going to say character 1. The next time it loops through, it's going to say character 2. And then is space, colon, space, then a tab. Remember this column, this comma concatenates all of this into one. This is a tab. So that is code for a tab, comma. And then the subset, string subset I. Now this is notation for the index of that. So this I love Julia exclamation mark, each and every character in that sentence has an index. And then comma, we're going to have, this is a new line. So I've just told you there, the comma concatenates the whole, the commas concatenate the whole lot. The backslash t is a tab, and the backslash n is a new line. Let's execute that so we can see what happens. And indeed, there we go. So it says character 1 is an I, character 2 is a space. So space counts, and that's how we get to 13 with the exclamation mark. So we've seen this index thing. Let's slice things up a bit. So I've still got this computer variable, string str underscore subset. And I want from index 1 to 6. So note these are square brackets and 1 to 6. And that is I love. So it's 1, 2 spaces, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 to 6, those characters. Let's see what happens if we take 8 till the end. I know the end is 13, but in case you didn't know what the length of your string was, you could just use end. So 8 to end was just going to be Julia exclamation mark. Let's reverse the order. That's a bit of fun. So this says go from end to the first one, but go back in steps of negative 1. So we're going to take our string and just reverse it. And that's quite clever. I think that's quite clever. So I love Julia, exclamation mark, all in reverse. Now just note the following, just in case you do run into this. Let's correct that spelling mistake there. That looks a lot better. Now note, if we just use 1, I'm just going to the index 1, which is just going to be I, and see it has single quotation marks, versus if I say 1 to 1, I'm going to get the double quotation marks. Now we're going to look at this a bit later. The single quotation marks refers to this as a character, a certain character, and this is just part of a string by the double quotation marks. Later on we'll see these single quotation marks. They are all about characters, and that is up next.